5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hi, this is Greg with BVBL. We're here in front of Heritage Hunt, where Gerry Connolly is holding a healthcare town hall meeting tonight, open only to residents of Heritage Hunt and not available for the actual constituents that have elected him. Let's go take a look and see what happened. As you can see, we've got about 100 people here out in front of Heritage Hunt. Old folks, young folks, lots of folks with signs. They're yelling, they're shouting, they're waving to the crowd. This is a really good turnout for Heritage Hunt. Gainesville doesn't tend to have a whole lot of these kind of protests and stuff. We've seen the local print media. We've seen some television crews. It looks like we're going to get some coverage of this event in the mainstream media as well. And we're going to go see if we can talk to some folks about what we're seeing here.
I believe the health care bill has to be reformed, but why can't it be done in 25 pages, written in plain English, so that all the congressmen and all of us people who are not lawyers can understand it?
And I'm here with Sharon, who's one of Gerry Connolly's constituents. Sharon, how do you feel about being stuck out here outside of his healthcare town hall instead of being inside, actually being able to participate?
I think it's pretty disgraceful when our representative can't even come and face us and consider our thoughts. And he's supposed to be representing us. We pay his wages. Why is he not listening to our thoughts and our beliefs?
So if you had an opportunity to say something to Gerry Connolly tonight, what would you tell him?
We do not want Obamacare. I came from a socialist country with socialist medicine. It's awful. It's horrible. We don't want it. We need capitalism. Bring it back.
What did you see back in, I assume, England? What did you see back in England with socialized medicine there?
The hospitals were falling apart. The staff were unhappy. There were short of people all the time. There were patients left in corridors because there was nowhere to put them. People waiting for years for surgeries and dying whilst they're waiting. No, we don't want that. This is a great system here. Everybody around the world comes to the US for healthcare because it's the best in the world. It would be crazy to turn it upside down and get rid of it.
Well, thank you very much. Hi, I'm here with Christina, a constituent of Gerry Connolly out in front of the healthcare town hall that he's not allowing her to go into. How does it make you feel that Gerry Connolly's only town halls right now require a permit and special permission in order to be able to see your congressional representative?
Yeah, I'm outraged by the cowardly behavior of Gerry Connolly in not having a town hall meeting where his actual constituents could show up. And in fact, I was at a protest in front of his office. We informed him of it several weeks in advance. He couldn't be bothered to show up and meet with us either. So, you know what? I don't think that you can be our representative if you refuse to ever meet with your constituents.
Well, with the question of health care that's the subject of tonight's town hall meeting, if you had an opportunity to ask Gerry Connolly a question or make a comment, what would you say about it?
Yeah, I'd like to point out that the people say that this is not going to force a whole bunch of people onto the government-run health care are wrong, because I work for a small company, and it'll be much cheaper for us to pay the 8% penalty and drop our health care. It'll also save us having to administer our health care, and it will save us having to buy insurance to cover our health care plan in case somebody doesn't get the proper health care and they sue us. So, you know, it will, in effect, automatically switch everyone in my company onto public health care.
Well, there you have it from another one of Gerry Connolly's constituents. Gerry Connolly, you're officially labeled Gerry the Coward. And now we've got Jane, one of Gerry Connolly's constituents, who's relegated to being out in front of Heritage Hunt's town hall rather than being in it. How does it make you feel that your congressman won't even allow you into his town hall events?
Well, I called his office about two or three times since the recess, asking him, will he please have a town hall meeting somewhere in the Gainesville Haymarket area? And at first they said his schedule wasn't put together yet. And then the second and third time I called back, and I talked to one of the younger guys, I called the Prince William office, and he said, oh, Gerry Connolly already had a meeting down in Woodbridge. And I said, well, I'm checking on the website, and I found nothing. So, and he said, oh, he'll have a town hall meeting. and it'll be on his website. So the way I found out about this was through Ron Wilcox, I think, or the guy, the Tea Party activist, and I'm thinking, so they're having one here that's invitation only, which I think is going to be a softball crowd.
So if you had an opportunity to be in the healthcare town hall meeting with your congressman, what would you ask him or what would you tell him about the healthcare bill?
I would tell him first that we're broke. I would tell him that I just don't understand where all this money is coming from. I don't understand the cap and trade, stimulus. Like, we just keep spending and spending, and I wonder if one day I'll wake up and China will own us, you know? So, and I'm a person who never got involved before. I'm raising kids, I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing this time in my life, and I'm out here protesting, so, because I feel so strongly about it.